Lots of people have asked me to summarize the book Quantum Body and share with you the key points. Note that what I and my co-authors say in this book is not mainstream quantum science, although slowly we are moving in that direction. What was fringe science in the 70s is becoming mainstream science now, but it takes time. So, what are the basic points in this book? The book proposes that the key to health, longevity, and well-being lies in understanding and harnessing the power of the quantum body. The unseen quantum body exists at the subatomic level of existence and is the invisible source of our physical reality and directly influences our thoughts, feelings, sensations, and biological responses. By the way, in Sanskrit, the idea of the quantum body is there, although not in these terms. In Sanskrit, in the yogic traditions, the quantum body is referred to as the causal body. And there are many layers to the body, like an onion has many layers. The outermost layer is matter and energy. Then the second layer is the subtle body, mind, intellect, and ego. Third layer is Jivatma and Brahman. And the third layer is also called the causal body or the body of bliss because it's beyond the karmic or conceptual body. So it's called Karan Sharir. Karan means cause in Sanskrit. So the physical body is called Sthul Sharir, physical, gross material. The subtle body of mind, intellect, and ego is called Sukshma Sharir. Sukshma means subtle. And then the causal body, Jivatma, is the body of your soul, the conditioned soul, the unconditioned soul, and the universal soul. It's called Karan Sharir, the causal body. That's the quantum body, which is one with the quantum field. The key points are as follows. Quantum body and the relationship with the physical body. The physical body is one which we can see, touch, subject to aging, injury, and decay, this physical body. But you know what we call physical is the alchemy of sensations, images, feelings, and thoughts, and it's constantly changing. The physical body is not a noun, it's a verb. The quantum body exists on the subatomic level and is infinite and invisible and serves as the blueprint for the physical body. The book goes through seven breakthroughs, which I can share later. It also outlines seven key principles for tapping into the power of the quantum body. The most important aspect of the book is what we call conscious awareness. Becoming aware and witnessing your thoughts and feelings helps you know their impact on your physical health. The book also proposes energy and information medicine, understanding how energy and information flow through the body and influence health. So, what is information? Information is memory, desire, imagination, intention. This is information, right? And every thought is an impulse of energy and information. So, I've mentioned this before, the thought, I'm going to wiggle my toes and this has different energy and information than the thought I'm going to Hawaii. Thoughts are impulses of energy and information, and we can say they are impulses of intelligence. The book also deals with the power of intention, recognizing the ability of your thoughts and intentions to shape your reality. And then the book goes very deeply into what we call super coherence, or entanglement, or non-local correlation. And supercoherence is achieving a state of harmony and alignment between the quantum body and the physical body. The book also addresses what timeless mind is, letting go of limiting beliefs about aging and embracing a timeless perspective, because the quantum body, not being in space and time, is timeless. And how we metabolize time influences how we age. This idea comes also from the Vedic tradition, which says time is the consumer and we are its food. We are time's food. So in all the aging research I've seen, nobody's talking about the metabolism of time. And the book suggests how we influence our body through time, but how to actually slow down the experience of time and ultimately transcend the experience of time altogether. When there's no time, there's no entropy. The book also discusses radical longevity, using the quantum body's potential to promote health and extend lifestyle. And it talks about a eudaimonic lifestyle, living a life of purpose, meaning, and connection to something greater than yourself. So the overall message of the quantum body in the book is, by understanding and nurturing the quantum body, we can unlock a new level of health, vitality, and longevity. In the book, you will see a number of practical exercises and meditations that will help the reader connect with their quantum body and experience its transformative power. How has the book been received? Well, it's received mixed reviews. Some readers are very enthusiastic about the book and praise its groundbreaking exploration of the connection between quantum physics and human health. While, of course, my old mainstream scientist friends, not all of them, but some of them, criticize that it is heavily spiritual and not conforming to mainstream physics ideas as much as they would have liked to have seen. Anyway, the book was co-authored by Jack Tuzinski, who's a quantum physicist and a quantum biologist, and a fellow endocrinologist, Brian Fertig, and they provide scientific insights to support my more philosophical and spiritual perspectives. So that's a summary of Quantum Body and what you could expect if you decide to read it. Thank you so much. Let me know your thoughts.